In this video, I want to show you how I made my own Shubkick microphone, which was something that I actually wanted to do for a long time, but I was too lazy to gather the parts needed for this project. Also, I have some tests between some different sized speakers that I had laying around here in the studio. So, without further ado, let's get into it. First of all, this whole project actually cost me absolutely nothing because I used parts that I had laying around here in the studio, and also I had a friend that was nice enough to give me an old speaker that he didn't need anymore. So let's get into the things that you will need to make this work. First of all, you will need an old crappy hi-fi speaker that nobody cares about. After that, you will need a dual cable as well as an XLR connector. To connect all this stuff together, you will need a soldering iron as well as solder. I guess also the knowledge on how to do some basic soldering. So we start by taking the speaker apart and removing the woofer, which is what we need for this DIY project. In my case, I also removed the mid driver, which was smaller, because I wanted to test how it would sound versus the woofer. The woofer was 5 inches big, while the mid driver I think is 2 or 3 inches big. So after totally destroying the speaker and throwing away the cabinet, all I had to do was to wire the XLR connector to the woofer. To do that, all I had to do was to wire the positive terminal of the speaker to the second pin of the XLR connector and the negative terminal to pin 3 of the XLR connector. And that was it. I did some basic tests with this setup and I realized that it would be much easier and much more fun to use spade connectors at the end of each cable so that I could swap speakers much more easily. So after desoldering the wire from the speaker and placing these connectors at the end of the wire, I was able to do a quick test between 3 speakers that I had here in the studio, and the results were pretty interesting. First of all, and mostly out of curiosity, I tried out the mid driver of the hi-fi speaker to see how it would sound on kick. And while it was funny, it's definitely something that is not usable unless you want something very specific on your kick sound. After that, I connected the 5-inch woofer of the hi-fi speaker, and this time the results were much closer to what I expected when I started building this thing. Last but not least, I tested a 10-inch Jensen guitar speaker that I had here in the studio and wasn't using at the time of the test, and the results weren't what I expected. The interesting part about the 10-inch speaker versus the 5-inch speaker was that the 10-inch had a peak around 100 Hz, while the 5-inch had a more balanced bottom end. Both speakers don't have a lot of information above 250 to 300 Hz, but that is the nature of this microphone. Anyway, I want to share this quick video about this project and tests I did a couple of days ago. I will definitely experiment with more speakers as time goes by in order to find one that sounds the best for this application. All in all, I've got to say that I liked the sound of the 5-inch a lot, and I am planning on using it in combination with another microphone on future projects. That's all for today. My name is Dalam. If you are interested in studio videos or guitar related stuff, consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.